We're recording.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Fairy Talk. And you know what? I already forgot exactly what I was going to talk about. So let me grab my list right away. I mean, I'd say my camera's maybe 10 feet from me. I read my list, walked over, you saw me, I was, hey, we're recording. And I already forgot what was on the list, you know. It's a long list. I mean, there's a whole three things on here I was supposed to remember. So, anyways, welcome back, guys. First off, I want to let you know, I appreciate you guys watching. I was going to try something different. I'm going to throw my next week's Fairy Talk over on my main channel. The username is Fairy Nick. I'm sure you guys are familiar, because where else would you have come from? But yeah, I'm going to throw that on my main channel, and I'm just trying things out. I have no idea. If you guys already haven't gotten a clue with this whole YouTube thing, I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm having fun, so, or else I don't think I'd be doing it. But anyways, it's been fun. It still is fun. So now that I'm done babbling about that. So anyways, like I said, just as a reminder, the next Fairy Talk I'm going to put on my main channel. It'll probably be on, I don't know, does Wednesday sound good with you guys? Sounds good to me. And that way, I'm just hoping that more people, it seems like on that other channel, people are interested. I've seen a couple comments, I've received a few emails saying, you know, you should do a wrap-up. And I'm like, well, this is kind of my wrap-up, because that's actually one thing I wanted to mention in this Fairy Talk. So, I'll put it over there. If it doesn't do well over there, I'll keep back and get over here and put them over here again. Who knows? Speaking of projects and wrap-ups, did you guys see my hand-cut dovetail video? Like I said, in the video, I didn't want it to be a tutorial or me trying to teach you how to do dovetails, because let's see here, 1, 2, 3, and then Cremona did one, so I've done a total of 3 dovetails now. So not even enough to make a whole box. I didn't want it to be a teaching experience. What I wanted you to get from that, or anyone that watches it, is if you think something's intimidating to woodworking, or if you think something is over your technical ability, so what? Give it a try. I mean, this is definitely over my technical ability because I haven't done it before. So that to me is like the beauty behind woodworking. You can create and make and build and to your heart's content. And there should be nothing stopping you from saying, I don't want to do it. I don't want to try it. Because you might find that you enjoyed it. And you know what? Those dovetails, I actually did enjoy them. I pulled up a stool and I just sat there and chiseled. And I had the radio on real quiet. And it was peaceful, you know. I could kind of hear my kids screaming from in the house, but that's why the radio was on a little bit. So anyways, so the takeaway. Am I going to review each and every time here? What I'm going to say it, and then I'm going to say, oh, I'm going to recap that in case you guys forgot what I said 30 seconds ago. Oh, going back to that. If you're uncomfortable with a certain tool, say a table saw, belt sand, I don't know who would be uncomfortable with that, but a band saw or something. If you're uncomfortable and there's a huge safety risk there, yeah, don't try it. Get some assistance. But something is, you know, maybe hop on the scroll saw if you've never done it before, or try the coping saw, try some of the hand tools, try sharpening something. Maybe you don't even plan on making anything. Pull out some of them old chisels. Try and sharpen those. I hope to have a sharpening video up in the next few weeks too, because I found a variety of methods on how to sharpen chisels, whether it be sandpaper or the expensive stones or some of the cheap stones, or some places sell the cheap diamond plates. So there is a variable just method of, you know, doing it, all the way from almost free to expensive. So anyways, get out there. You know, you might be thinking, oh, that project is too tough. To break it down into steps, try it. Let me know if you guys do try something that you haven't before, because for whatever reason, and you're like, you know what, I heard Nick say this and I tried it, because that's my goal. I want to see you guys try something. And I will be doing hand-cut dovetails in the future, whether it's in videos or not. I will be doing them in the future. It's something I enjoy now. So maybe I'll even put Danish oil on that one. Anyways, also with the dovetails, I had a couple people ask about when I was back at my shop, when I was back from Cremona's at my shop, and the wood was moving around. Yes, one of the takeaways for me for the dovetails was secure that workpiece and get it in a fashion to where it's going to be comfortable for you to work on it. That was one thing I kind of struggled with at my own shop. This summer, fingers crossed, I'm hoping to build a solid workbench that I will have from here on out. I have had a variety of workbenches throughout part of the not editing. Look at that. Ding, ding, ding. Now I got it on vibrate. I've had quite a few workbenches over the years, whether it be some 2x4 screwed to a wall, some sort of particle board and angle iron thing that I got from the home center, whatever it may be. I want the workbench that I will have for the rest of my life. So hopefully, if everything goes well, I will build a workbench this summer, and that will definitely be a video. I'm hoping it'll be out of rock maple. I have a nice maple supplier nearby, and it's reasonable for me to get. And I want it to look nice, and I want it to have some of the features. I want to incorporate some of the features from hand tool work, but then also just your average everyday power tool hand tool work. So anyways, look forward to that if you stick around for that. Going back to that, that was what I wanted to mention. I posted a picture on Instagram of my dovetails in progress while I was still at Cremona's, and Storm701, hey Storm, wanted to know what that type of clamp was, and he was referring to the picture where I have a holdfast in, it's right next to where I was making the dovetails. And I don't own a holdfast, so I will put a picture right here. That is something I want to incorporate in my new bench, and it's basically just an angular piece of metal that is bent, and from what I can gather, it has to be kind of like an annealed metal. It can't be cast. Cast is too brittle. But it kind of flexes out. You tap the top of it, you know, however hard you want to tap it, and it holds it into the hole, kind of wedging itself in the hole and wanting to, you know, kind of expand back and get its memory back. And you just tap the back of it, and it's a very quick and easy way to hold something down to a workbench. You can not only put those dog holes in the tops of workbenches, but I've seen them in the sides, I've seen them in the legs, I've seen them... So, you know, and you can use those little dogs that go in there with side vents, side vices, tail vices, and whatnot. So that I will be incorporating into my workbench, hopefully. CNC. I was contacted by Inventables, and this upcoming Friday's video will be of me putting together my CNC. I am the type of person to want and to expand my channel into the electronics, the pneumatics, mold making and stuff like that. I'm not just a woodworker. I do a lot of theater scenery and props and different, well, I don't know if you want to call them animatronics, but a lot of pneumatic actuated stuff. So a CNC will come out, will come in handy for me. I don't know how many videos I'll do with it because not everyone is going to have the money to drop on a CNC. I know I didn't. They wanted me to test it out, see how easy it is to assemble and kind of give an overall honest opinion, which you guys will have to trust my integrity on the opinion because they gave it to me for free. So I don't watch a whole lot of channels to where I see the people as kind of shady. So hopefully you guys don't see me as that way. But yeah, no, that'll be interesting in the future. A couple other things were given to me. This one I actually asked for. Inventable contacted me, Inventables. This one I actually asked for. I have a project coming up where I wanted to use more pocket holes and the little clamp on the smaller unit worked well, but I wanted to start incorporating more pocket holes, and I wanted to try that new K5 system, and Craig was nice enough to send me one, and I will give you guys a heads up. There will be something on the website. Craig's also going to throw one in, so that they're doing a giveaway on that, and that's just awesome, so look for that over on the website. It should start and run through March. So I just wanted to tell you guys in advance before I say anything else on my other channel. So the last thing, as this video is probably running long, the last thing I had to mention was everything in a video. That's all I wrote down on my little note card. I wish I could throw more information in the build videos. I really do. But you look at, you know, different types of channels on YouTube. You look at different lengths of videos, and people aren't watching, traditionally, people aren't watching the 20, 30, 40 minute long videos. They just aren't. I mean, anything, it seems to me, almost anything over 10 minutes, people are apprehensive to want to watch. So I want the information that I give you to be easy to digest, to where if you got 5, 6, 7 minutes free in your life and you want to click it and watch it and move on, great. Now, granted, there's the exception to the rule. I mean, Sellers does awesome videos where he teaches you very much in depth a lot of hand tool stuff. And those longer videos for him, for sure, they're warranted. But I want to give more of an overview. And at least at this point in time, I don't get a whole lot of emails and I don't get a whole lot of questions. So it's, you know, the questions that do come in, I'm able to email people back, I think, and let them know, hey, this is what I used, or this is my technique that I prefer here. So that was, do you guys want 20-minute long videos? You can let me know in the comments section, but I always try to hit that 6-minute mark. That just seems to be a good time to sit down, watch a video, and catch a 6-minute video. And I fully understand that I'm not the only one on here on YouTube. So you guys follow all sorts of people, and you know, if each video was 20 minutes long, I think some of us would have to quit our day jobs just to watch YouTube videos. Which I don't know about our spouses, but I don't think they'd be too happy. Oh, I'm gonna quit my job. Yeah, what are you gonna do? I'm gonna watch YouTube videos all day. And don't say I said you could. that about wraps it up. You guys take care until I see you next time. Like I said, it'll be on the main channel, at least for next week. Who knows after that? See you later.